Hi, my name is Louis Shamra. I'm the Dean School of Engineering and Computer Science. I want to welcome all of you to Oakland and the School of Engineering and Computer Science, and I'm going to say congratulations on starting a new adventure and new career, college career. Here at Oakland, we pride ourselves in giving excellent educational experience for all our students, regardless of gender or ethnic background or different experiences at home and outside. We value your education, and despite the COVID-19 pandemic, we always put the quality of our education outside and inside the classroom as our top priority. Oakland University, we always pride ourselves in doing theory and practice. Hands-on experience is very important. That's why we're gonna try very hard to have in-person labs at Oakland University this fall, because I really believe engineering and computer science, having the hands-on experience is very important. And right now, because of that theory and practice, over 85% of our students get an internship before they graduate, and 95% have a job one semester before they graduate. So I wish you the best at Oakland University, and you have, if you need any help, my door is always open. I have an open door policy for especially the student, and I'm always here to help you and make sure that you are successful. Congratulations again, and welcome to Oakland University.
Hello and welcome to Oakland University. My name is Jeff Carl, and I'm an admissions advisor with Undergraduate Admissions. We are excited that you have chosen to attend our Go for the Gold program. As a quick reminder, there is a Q&A chat function on this webinar. You may notice two chat boxes. Please only place your questions in the Q&A box so all of the moderators can see them. If your questions don't get answered right away, we may be saving them for the panel later in the presentation. I would like to start off by telling you a little bit about Oakland's history, academic programs, and campus life, in addition to admissions and scholarship information. Oakland University was founded in 1957 thanks to a $2 million donation by Alfred and Matilda Wilson. We are a young university, which is exciting because there is constant room for growth. OU is home to over 19,000 students, with more than 3,000 of which who live on campus. OU has more than 120,000 alumni worldwide. Nearly 75% of OU alumni live in Michigan. Oakland University has a beautiful campus of 1,443 acres and is home to Meadowbrook Hall, one of Michigan's National Historic Landmarks. Also, all of our academic buildings are centrally located on campus for ease of access. Our campus is surrounded by entertainment venues such as Meadowbrook Amphitheater right here on campus, which has hosted big-name artists like Nick Jonas, Steve Aoki, Kendrick Lamar, and 5 Seconds of Summer. Oakland is also close to shopping areas with various options like Great Lakes Crossing and downtown Rochester. If you are into recreation, check out the nearby Paint Creek Trail, the Clinton River Trail, and the Stony Creek Metro Park. In addition, there are OU-sponsored events such as movie nights at Imagine and on-campus drive-ins, as well as OU Night at Comerica Park. During the fall, Yates Cider Mill is a big destination for delicious cider and fresh donuts. Oakland University proudly boasts one of the lowest crime rates in Oakland County and the number one safest public university in Michigan, and the third nationally, partially due to the many safety features in use around campus. There are over 100 blue lights all across campus, which will connect anyone directly to the OUPD dispatch. They also offer text message alerts that will send a notification directly to your phone in the event of an emergency situation on campus. Students and parents are both eligible to receive these and can enroll on OUPD's website. OUPD officers are on campus 24/7, 365 days a year. More than 3,000 students live on campus, calling one of our residence halls or apartments home. Hamlin Hall houses first-year students, and Oakview Hall is the newest home to the Honors College. We are excited about the opening of our newest residence hall, Hillcrest Hall, which houses 750 students and has a new cafeteria and a satellite recreation center. We also offer special interest floors, which offer social and academic support. Student involvement plays a large role in the lives of our students. OU offers more than 300 student organizations, including academic, social, Greek, political, and spiritual groups. The university regularly plans trips to fun places like New York City, Chicago, or Boston. Our Office for Student Involvement also offers discounted tickets to various events and performances throughout the Metro Detroit area. OU has 18 men's and women's varsity sports. OU competes in the NCAA Division I athletics as a part of the Horizon League. The Golden Grizzlies have brought home 28 regular season titles, 77 conference tournament titles, and have made 55 NCAA tournament appearances. For more information, please visit OUGrizzlies.com. At Oakland, we encourage students to live, study, or work within a different culture through more than 180 study abroad programs in over 40 countries. For example, our students studying a concentration in archaeology can travel to Israel to see historic and religious sites covered in class, participate in an archaeological dig, and conduct groundbreaking research. Oakland offers 140 undergraduate programs and more than 130 graduate and certificate programs. These are divided into several professional schools and one liberal arts and sciences college. Please refer to oakland.edu/academics for more information. Whether you are deciding on a major or still exploring your options, the First Year Advising Center provides academic advising for all first-year students, students who are undecided or redeciding their majors past their first year, as well as undecided transfer students. Your assigned advisor will introduce you to helpful resources and tools to assist you in developing a balanced schedule and making informed decisions about your major and your future career. The Honors College offers a unique environment for high-achieving students through smaller class sizes and special topic general education courses, and gives graduating seniors the opportunity to complete a thesis in a topic of their choosing. Students with a 3.7 GPA or higher and a test score of a 1200 SAT or 25 ACT are automatically qualified for the Honors College. Those students who have above a 3.3 GPA and a test score of 1000 on the SAT must complete a separate application in addition to an interview for consideration. OU's Presidential Scholar Award recipients are automatically accepted into the Honors College. Of course, all undergraduate majors are welcome to apply to this challenging, unique environment for high-achieving students. This year, we were proud to say that we had a record-breaking entering class of 663 new Honors College students. The School of Engineering and Computer Science features outstanding faculty dedicated to preparing learners for the 21st century workplace and society, as well as for research in their fields of specialization. The School of Engineering and Computer Science opened a 127,000 square foot engineering complex in the heart of campus in 2014. The engineering center includes state-of-the-art instructional, research, and developmental space designed to foster students' learning and creativity that will ultimately boost U.S. global competitiveness in alternative energy, healthcare, biomedical, automotive, defense, and other high-tech industries. The Oakland University William Beaumont School of Medicine will welcome its 10th class in the fall of 2020. Students receive instruction in basic sciences and research at OU and take part in a clinical training and applied research at Beaumont Health Systems. The school is a member of an elite group, one of just 141 MD-granting medical schools in the country. As I mentioned previously, Nursing Direct Admit is one of OU's academically competitive programs. A limited number of entering freshmen will be offered direct admission to the university's School of Nursing Basic BSN track. Students interested in attending OU in the fall should apply by November 15th of their senior year to be considered for the Direct Admit Nursing Program. To be considered for OU's Business Honors Direct Admit Program, you must gain admission and complete a supplemental application, although we recommend you have your application in by December 1st of your senior year in high school. As I mentioned earlier, students wishing to study in the Department of Music, Theater, and Dance must gain admission to the university, then apply for an audition with the department. The school is accepting video auditions now through August 17th. You can register for an audition at oakland.edu/smtd and see their audition information on the website. You will be sent virtual audition guidelines, and students who are applying for the fall of 2021 can find audition dates online at oakland.edu/smtd. I'd now like to walk you through the process of applying to Oakland University. Applying is easy, and the application can be found online at oakland.edu/apply. The application is free, and we are currently accepting applications for winter, summer, and fall of 2020, and the fall of 2021 applications will be opening on July 1st. The average incoming freshman has a 3.5 GPA and a score of 1130 on the SAT or a score of a 25 on the ACT. Typically, OU will admit first-year students with a 2.5 cumulative grade point average. For the fall of 2020 and the fall of 2021, we have temporarily shifted to test optional admissions in light of the COVID-19 pandemic. SAT or ACT scores are not required for admissions consideration for the fall of 2020 and 2021. Students are still encouraged to send a test score, if and when they have them, for course placement or additional scholarship consideration. Our average incoming transfer student has a 3.1 GPA. Generally, transfer students with college credit and a 2.5 GPA or higher are admitted. Transfer students must submit all transcripts from every college they have attended. However, transfer students with fewer than 24 college credits must also submit their high school transcript. Scholarship consideration for OU is automatic. There is no separate application for merit scholarships. To receive fall scholarship consideration, we recommend incoming freshman students to apply and have all materials submitted to OU by March 1st of their senior year of high school. While scholarship consideration is based upon your cumulative grade point average and test score at the time of admission, students are welcome to submit updated transcripts and test scores to be reconsidered for scholarships. Transfers should apply by December 1st for winter scholarship consideration or August 1st for fall semester. Transfer scholarship consideration is also based upon the student's cumulative grade point average at the time of admissions. Please see the scholarships and grant information located on our website for more information. Currently, tuition is assessed based upon the class standing, the course, and course level. Differential tuition rates also apply to courses offered by the School of Health Sciences, School of Business Administration, School of Nursing, the School of Engineering and Computer Science, regardless of major. For more specific information and to view the rates by course and course level, please refer to oakland.edu/tuition. University housing offers a variety of living options suited to your individual needs and interests. Housing rates and more information can be found online at oakland.edu/housing. For all newly admitted students planning to attend OU, we encourage that you activate your accounts if you haven't already. Activating your account will allow you to choose your NetID, which will act as your OU email address. Activate your account today at oakland.edu/activate. If you have been offered any merit scholarships, you will also want to go to oakland.edu/scholar-accept to accept them. Additionally, all incoming students are encouraged to register for new student orientation. Registration is available online at oakland.edu/orientation to lock in your spot in our incoming class. These events will be held virtually throughout the summer on the dates that you are signing up for. For those students attending OU in the fall of 2020, application for housing is now available. Students may apply at oakland.edu/housing/apply. For those students starting OU in the winter of 2021, applications to live on campus will be available beginning November 1st. I would like to also stress the importance of the financial aid process. To be considered for financial aid, students must complete the FAFSA, the Free Application for Federal Student Aid. This form is available now and can be completed at FAFSA.gov. That is FAFSA.gov. Additionally, for those of you who have yet to take the SAT, or for those still planning to retake the SAT and looking to improve their scores for scholarship consideration, we would like to remind you that Khan Academy offers free SAT prep for students. Khan Academy is a great resource if you're looking to continue on working towards improving your test scores and can be found at khanacademy.org. I want to encourage each of you to visit us virtually to learn even more about the application process. At this time, we will move on to the next presentation, and as a reminder, feel free to use the Q&A chat box to submit any questions you have throughout today. Don't forget, we will also have a panel at the end.
Hello, and thank you for joining us today. My name is Gregory Ash, and I'm a Senior Financial Aid Outreach Advisor with Student Financial Services. I'm happy to be here with you today to share some information about financial aid at Oakland University and answer any questions you might have. Today, I'll talk about costs to consider when attending college, how to apply for financial aid from a variety of sources, and the types of aid you will be eligible to receive from Oakland University, the state and federal governments, as well as private resources. Please feel free to submit your questions during the presentation, and I'll take some time at the end to answer them for you. When attending college, there are many costs to consider. Oakland prides itself on being a fee-free institution, so the only billable charges you'll have are tuition and housing, if you choose to live on campus. Even the laundry and toilet paper in housing are free. You should also expect to have expenses related to your education, but not billed directly by Oakland University, such as books, living off campus or at home, transportation, and living expenses. When Student Financial Services is preparing your financial aid offer, we estimate these billable charges and non-billable expenses, then add them together to determine the cost of attendance. Financial aid is intended to provide you options to pay for your billable charges and help to pay for your non-billable expenses. So the cost of attendance is the maximum amount of financial aid you are offered. In order to pay for college, students can be eligible for financial aid, including scholarships, grants, work study, and loans. In order to apply for financial aid, students should complete the Free Application for Federal Student Aid, also known as the FAFSA. Most financial aid requires the FAFSA, and when we say file early, we mean it. The FAFSA should be completed beginning October 1st, or shortly thereafter, of the student's senior year of high school. Some financial aid is offered on a first-come, first-served basis. One of the reasons we recommend filing the FAFSA when it becomes available October 1st to apply for the next school year. You can file the FAFSA electronically on FAFSA.gov or using the My Student Aid app available for iOS and Android devices. If you have your phone or tablet handy, you can open your camera and point it at the QR code for whichever operating system you use. A banner will open when you can download the app. While there is a paper application for FAFSA, it is recommended you file electronically for a variety of reasons. Filing the FAFSA electronically is much faster to process. It takes just 3 to 5 days, and there are a number of security measures taken to ensure your information remains private, such as the data retrieval tool, which allows most users to upload their tax information right from the IRS website. The electronic FAFSA is also shorter and much more relevant to your household because it uses skip logic to eliminate questions that no longer apply to you based on the questions you've already answered. If you need help completing the FAFSA, Student Financial Services offers free private appointments for anyone who needs help completing the application. Oakland University Undergraduate Admissions automatically awards OU merit-based scholarships through the admissions process, so no additional applications are required. Student Financial Services automatically awards our need-based grants when processing the FAFSA. Every student who qualifies for scholarships and grants is guaranteed to receive the award. We are not limited to the number of students who receive the award. Annual departmental scholarships are also available through Oakland University Academic and Student Services Department. For application and selection, beginning due the student's first year. Oakland University offers a number of need-based grants available to students who complete the FAFSA and meet certain eligibility criteria. The Golden Grizzly Tuition Guarantee Grant is offered to first-time freshmen who are Michigan residents with the expected family contribution of less than $8,000 as determined by the FAFSA. The award pays the remaining amount of tuition due after subtracting the amount of the expected family contribution and any other gift aid. This award is renewable for up to 4 years or 8 semesters. The OU Golden Grant is awarded up to $5,000 per year and is renewable for up to 4 years or 8 semesters. It is awarded to first-time freshmen who are Michigan residents with a high school GPA of 3.0 and an expected family contribution of less than $8,000. The OU Housing Grant is awarded up to $5,000 per year and is renewable for up to 4 years or 8 semesters. It's awarded to first-time freshmen who are Michigan residents with a high school GPA of 3.0 and an expected family contribution of less than $8,000. Students who receive the housing grant must live on campus with housing charges for a full semester that are not covered by another housing award. Student employment is also available at OU and may be part of the student's financial aid offer if they receive a work-study grant. Work-study and non-work-study positions are available at OU, and the university employs about 1,600 student employees each year. Students are paid at least minimum wage. However, some positions pay more. Students are limited to a maximum of 25 hours per week during the fall and winter semesters. Students can work up to 40 hours per week when classes are not in session and during the summer semester. On-campus and local jobs are posted on OU Handshake, a platform that will grow with the student over time. Students can use Handshake to also apply for internships in their later years at OU, as well as professional positions when they graduate. The federal government offers financial aid to students, including grants, work study, student and parent loans. Some grants are offered on a first-come, first-served basis, like the SEOG and work study grants. One of the reasons it is important to complete the FAFSA as soon as possible on October 1st, the federal government also offers student loans, awarded to the student in the student's name only. Parents are not co-signers for federal loans. The subsidized loan is interest-free while the student is in school, and the unsubsidized loan accrues interest while the student is in school. Neither loan requires payment until 6 months after graduation. However, there is no penalty for each repayment. A Parent Plus loan may also be offered for parents to borrow in their own name. It is a credit-worthy loan, so if you're approved and want to use it, you can. But if you're denied, the student gets an additional amount of an unsubsidized loan in their own name. It is an opportunity to receive additional federal aid without going to a bank or a private lender, which is often a more expensive option for student. The state of Michigan also provides financial aid to students and requires the FAFSA to be completed no later than March 1st in the student's senior year. The Michigan Competitive Scholarship is awarded automatically to students who complete the FAFSA and achieve a 1200 or better on the SAT. The other awards offered by the state require an application, which is available through the MySSG student account. Students can create their MySSG student account after they file their first FAFSA. Private scholarships are also available through organizations, foundations, and companies, and students are encouraged to begin applying for these scholarships in the junior year. Students should apply regularly until they graduate from college to increase their chances to receive a greater number of scholarships. College Board, FastWeb, and GoodCall are some of the many scholarship search engines students can use to apply for private scholarships. It is also a great idea to check with the high school counseling office for local scholarships aimed at students in the school or community. Some students may also have personal resources like a MET or an MESP or other college savings plans to help them pay for their education expenses. OU is proud to offer payment plans for students who choose to pay all or a portion of their charges on their own. Payment plans are available each semester a student attends to divide payments into four equal payments. Payment plans are interest-free, and students can easily pay with a checking or savings account. Credit and debit cards are also accepted, and students are encouraged to schedule their payments to pay automatically each month. I hope you feel better prepared for the cost associated with college and more familiar with the financial aid available to you. To prepare for paying for college, there are a few things you can do even now. If you'd like to learn more about the financial aid process, please join me for a virtual financial aid presentation. Visit oakland.edu/financial-events for the schedule and link to join. Students and parents can visit studentaid.gov to create an FSA ID necessary to access and complete the FAFSA. Make sure you apply for private scholarships regularly to increase the number of scholarships you will use to pay for your education. Finally, make sure you file the FAFSA beginning October 1st of your senior year and every year thereafter. If you have questions after today, please contact Student Financial Services to speak with an advisor. We are open Monday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. and are currently taking phone calls remotely. You can also visit our website at oakland.edu/financial-services, where all of the information in this presentation is also available. You're also welcome to email our office at finservices@oakland.edu. Thank you again for attending our virtual Go for the Gold event today. I'm happy to answer any questions you may have.
Hi, my name is Chris Kobus. I am the Director of Outreach, Recruitment, and Retention for the School of Engineering and Computer Science. I work directly with Louis Sharma, who is the Dean of the school. The picture that you are seeing here is the Engineering Center where the School of Engineering and Computer Science is housed. It is a building that is about 6 years old, state-of-the-art, and was built for only education. So that is our home. So who are we in the School of Engineering and Computer Science at Oakland University?
Oakland University students form meaningful relationships with dedicated and engaged faculty who provide the connections students need to take their learning to the next level. OU's School of Engineering and Computer Science offers instruction leading to degrees at the bachelor's, master's, and doctoral levels. The programs are offered through four departments: Computer Science and Engineering, Electrical and Computer Engineering, Industrial and Systems Engineering, and Mechanical Engineering. The School of Engineering and Computer Science features an outstanding faculty dedicated to preparing learners for the 21st century workplace and society, as well as for research in their fields of specialization. The school offers close student-faculty interaction, small classes, and individualized attention. The goal of the School of Engineering and Computer Science is to provide students, faculty, and staff with the best educational and working experience in a highly supportive yet stimulating environment. Oakland is a rare public university that encourages undergraduate research as early as the freshman year. Students can conduct hands-on multidisciplinary research with professors who are published experts in their fields. Engineering and computer science faculty provide the highest quality of education, which is enhanced by cutting-edge research sponsored by federal agencies and industrial partners. On campus, the home of the School of Engineering and Computer Science is the 127,000 square foot Engineering Center, which features state-of-the-art classrooms and research spaces and a courtyard for student organizations.
So that's a little bit about us. And that building, if it symbolizes anything, is our commitment to the students. All our professors are there in their offices, but there are large sections of that building that are all labs, all educational labs. They are there for support for classes, hands-on experiences, design projects, and also some spaces for our student organizations. In 2019, we saw our largest ever freshman class. We had over 500 students in the freshman class. And this picture right here is right after convocation, which is the official welcome of freshman students. Our students are all wearing orange here because that is the color of engineering. Gives you a little bit of feel for what it's like inside the building, some of the technology and the space that we have. So a little bit about our enrollment. On the left-hand side here is our School of Engineering and Computer Science enrollment. So right now, as of fall 2019, we were getting close to 3,000 undergraduates and an additional 852 graduates. On the right-hand side, you can see the enrollment numbers for the entire university. So we are a significant unit in the university, and we continue to grow. On the research side, our focus is heavily on applied research. It doesn't mean we don't do fundamental research, but we do a lot of applied research, the reason being that we have a great deal of industry in the area, and those form really good research partnerships. So applied research is more about research in action, getting it into the stage where it's practical and can be applied to products and services in industry. One of the interesting things about Oakland University is that historically we have opened up our research labs to undergraduate students. That means that anywhere from the freshman year on up, if really interested students, self-motivated, want to get a research experience, something in class maybe triggers an interest and they develop a relationship with their professor, they have an opportunity to get into the lab and actually do some real research. We have four departments, although a fifth one is coming online now, which I'll address in just a moment, but we have industrial and systems engineering, electrical and computer engineering, computer science and engineering, and mechanical engineering. In the Department of Electrical and Computer Engineering, so what we're talking about is analog and digital circuits, wireless communications. And you can see here, some of these are student projects and some of these are research areas that we have. One of the pictures that you see of the car on the platform there is an antenna array where there's testing being done for how well cars communicate with satellites. And that long arm goes all the way around 180 degrees from one side of the ground to the other. And that car also rotates 360 degrees on its axis on that platform. We have an aerial robotic vehicle club that is very active, and they were making drones before drones were popular. Microprocessor control is one of the things that students learn very early on in classes, as early as their sophomore year. We have an entire class called Design of Electromechanical Systems. And that has far-reaching applications all over industry. In the area of computer science and engineering, what we're talking about here is primarily coding, but also includes IT and topics such as cybersecurity, which reading the newspaper on any day, you can read articles about data breaches and how important it is that data, information is protected. In industrial and systems engineering, this one is perhaps the most unique out of all the departments in that the focus is not on making products, but to optimize processes. So for instance, in an assembly line, you have machines and humans that interact. How do you make it such that that process runs smoothly, that the people working alongside these robots are not in harm's way, are the most productive they can be, don't get bored, don't have repetitive movement injuries, and that sort of thing. Just for an example of this would be a hospital. A hospital is a system that an engineer like this would be looking at. In a hospital, you have patients, you have doctors, you have nurses, you have staff, you have supplies, and you have information. And all of that is a large system that has to work precisely. So an industrial systems engineer would be one that would look at that as a system and go about optimizing it, making it work better. Mechanical engineering is a very conventional department. There is a solid mechanics side to mechanical engineering, and there is a fluid thermal side also. And both of those are mechanical engineering. So We're looking at primarily parts and processes. A lot of application, of course, to the automotive industry here in terms of internal combustion engines, whether it's the internal combustion engine itself or the cooling of it. It could also be electronic component cooling. It could be internal combustion engines, the design of the engine itself, or just the belts, the moving parts, or on the fluid thermal side, getting the oil into the engine properly, getting a cooling jacket around that engine to cool it properly. Those are all kinds of topics that go along with mechanical engineering. We also have the engineering sciences, which are programs that are housed in the four departments: engineering chemistry, engineering physics, and bioengineering is becoming our newest department. That's going to be our fifth department. And that brings a lot of excitement these days. Our faculty are by and large active researchers. We have research going on in all of the departments all the time, funded by National Science Foundation, funded by the Department of Energy, funded by local industry. A lot of partnerships going forward with research. Some of our research is centered around autonomous vehicles. What you see right in top there is an autonomous shuttle that we started on campus. Of course, with the area being so new, there were a few bugs in the system, so we took that shuttle offline and are redoing that. You may not know it, but we have had an autonomous vehicle competition on the Oakland University campus since the early 1990s, back when nobody knew what an autonomous vehicle was. So that's one of the things that we have world-renowned faculty that have been studying this for a very, very long time, not recently, but going back to the 1980s even. What you see here is a video of a drone, and Oakland University was actually a winner of a global competition to design a drone that had operational modes underwater and also on the air side. So the drone could fly out to anywhere, basically out in the middle of the ocean, maybe in bad weather, maybe a dangerous place that has chemical spills, radioactivity, and that kind of thing, where you wouldn't want a person to go. And this drone would fly out there and actually go underwater and do some reconnaissance and see maybe where the leak's coming from or that sort of thing. So what you're seeing here, this is called the Looncopter, and it won that global competition in 2016. There were over 1,000 entries from 165 countries, and Oakland University came out as number one. And yes, we did get a $1 million check as the first place winners. So again, this is another example of having world-renowned, world-class faculty that are at the top of their field. And these are the same faculty that are teaching the students. Senior design is one thing that we require of all of our students. So before you graduate in your senior year, you are part of a team that's multidisciplinary. It's made up of mechanical engineers and electrical engineers and computer engineers. And they work with primarily local industry. And this could be companies and this could be inventors to design products. Last year, 11 of our 13 senior design projects were externally funded. That means that these groups were working with companies or individuals. We also have a very active community engagement arm that is also externally funded, for instance, an AT&T grant to support K-12 STEM outreach workshops. We run workshops throughout the year. We run summer camps throughout the summer. We have STEM field trips in the fall and the winter. So very healthy community engagement going all the way down to the elementary school level. We have student organizations for robotics and unmanned systems. They build vehicles. Some of them are autonomous. These student groups travel with these vehicles to competitions throughout the United States and even globally. We have a very active research area in power, energy, and smart grids trying to decrease the environmental footprint of everything that we do. Sustainability is perhaps the biggest challenge of this generation and possibly the next generation, where we figure out how to do everything we want to do, but to minimize the environmental footprint for doing it. The School of Engineering and Computer Science has a very high job placement record. In fact, the vast majority of our students find work not after graduation, but before graduation. The economy has been doing so good in recent years that a lot of our students used to be hired away as interns in the summer with part-time work during the fall and winter, and then juniors started getting hired, and then sophomores started getting hired, and this last year we saw a lot of freshmen also place into internships. So by the numbers, 99% of our graduates are employed with a starting salary of $65,000 or more. More than three quarters of them have completed some kind of an internship. And these internships are not unpaid internships, they are all paid at a pretty good pay rate. And almost half of our students found those opportunities not by themselves, but working with our career services department. And one number that we are very proud of is that 97% of our graduates not only find jobs, but they find jobs right here in Michigan. They stay in the state and add to the economy. We have a great number of student organizations. These are some of the most active ones. Anything from the National Society of Black Engineers to the Society of Women's Engineers to the Makers Club to the Society of Automotive Engineers. There's almost an area for any interested engineering student to come in and get their feet wet right away. And many of these clubs are very active throughout the year. A lot of friendship bonds are formed. And being involved in one of these clubs, and maybe even being a leader in one of these clubs, adds to the resume. Grizzly Racing, so the Society of Automotive Engineers, every year they build a formula car from scratch. That means designing the frame on a computer, welding the frame together. Everything is built in a garage space that the Society of Automotive Engineers has. And they take this car around throughout the United States and internationally, and they race. These competitions are not pure races. There's a lot of points assigned to design, the fact that everything meets specifications, and other aspects of the design process. We also run a lecture series that is geared towards our freshmen and sophomore students. These lecture series are leaders from local industry that come in and talk about what it's like out there. Our freshmen and sophomore students, even the ones that know they want to be electrical engineers, may not be aware of everything the electrical engineers do out there. So we have speakers come in from all the different disciplines, usually once a month. We invite all the students to come, we feed them pizza and soda, and they listen for about an hour or so with questions at the end of these speakers telling them how important some of the things that they learn in school are. why you want to study and get the good grades, and then what has been their experience once they go out there? What do they actually do as an electrical engineer, as a mechanical engineer, as an industrial engineer? And this has been a great success. This is a series that was started about 3 years ago. We also have not so much extracurricular but in-curricular programs such as ClickForm. This is the Chrysler Learning and Innovation Center, where student cohorts who are accepted into this program learn about stamping and metal forming, not just from the professors at Oakland University, but in conjunction with Chrysler. This comes with internships in the stamping plants. Students that are interested in this as a career opportunity tend to get a great deal out of getting into ClickForm. And the employer, in this case Chrysler, always also gets to know their possible future employees very well over the course of a couple of years. A similar program we have in Powertrain called the Powertrain Readiness Engineering Program, or PREP. This again is a program that students can apply for in their junior year, but in this case, the focus is on powertrain rather than metal forming. Several times a year, we host hackathons where students get together. Several times a year, we hold hackathons where students get together, and over the course of about a day and a half, they're on the computer trying to solve some pretty complex problems. We have a makers club, where makers club basically is a club where we're building things, little robots and devices, a lot of electromechanical systems, a lot of microprocessor controls. We have an aerial systems club, and this is a club that started many years ago, just building drones. And of course, that led into building the Looncopter that won that international competition. We have a robotics association, and part of what the robotics association does is they build an autonomous robot every year, brand new, and goes into competition against other international teams. We have a very active chapter of the Society of Women Engineers. One of the things we encourage with our community engagement program is trying to get more women into engineering. If you have any further questions, please look us up at www.oakland.edu/secs. There's a full directory in there, including the dean's office. So please feel free to ask questions.